With Patrick and his knee, you said you're going to monitor. Is there any chance that this might be more than just rest?
Certainly hope not. And the good news is I won't be monitored. Actually, the doctors will be, so that'll be good. But if this is something, I think, oh, just over the last week or so, started to bother him a bit. So when he got back, got looked at, and, you know, at this point, being more cautious and careful than anything, and, you know, and actually providing some other opportunity for some other players as well. So so we'll just monitor him, the doctors will, and just kind of see how he's doing, how he responds, and hopefully there'll be no red flags along the way, and hopefully be back, and, you know, long season to go, and certainly 7 exhibition games as well. So we'll take our time and make sure we do the right thing.
Did something specific happen?
No, I think it might be just over time, I believe. It was nothing. He hasn't had surgery in that knee or something that I'm not aware of, and just something over time that has started to bother him just recently. I don't think there was anything last year in his games for because of this, and so hopefully that's good news. We'll kind of see where it goes, and again, be more cautious than anything.
Did he have an MRI or anything?
No, I don't think that required an MRI. I don't think this was just something that has been bothering him, and, you know, so, you know, he'll go through the strength and routine and working with the doctors and off ice, and eventually get back on the ice on his own. And kind of ramp it up at some point. So when we get to that point, you'll see him.
Is your timetable on Boucher?
No, not yet. Just one of those things, the protocol by the concussion, as we know what that is, but he's feeling better. But I think it's more important. Again, the same thing. You have to be cautious of these things. And so we'll see how he's feeling when, you know, when he passes baseline again and can continue to work out. We'll get him back on the ice, and, you know, I don't think he's had a concussion before. I don't think that really matters anyway. But again, taking your time with these things and making sure that you're cautious with him. And when he finally gets cleared to play and get back on the ice and participate, he'll do that.
So he's still not working out at all.
I think he is off ice. He is working. You know, it's one of those things in terms of with a lot of these things when you suffer the concussion, it's more of active rest, if you know what I mean. So he's been active, and but, you know, doctors are monitoring that as well, and I just go through the regular protocol with them. So,
other than the fact that he still is technically a player on this team or in this organization, mm-hmm. is there a reason why Klo is watching things and hanging around?
Yeah, that's a good question. No, there is. Yeah, with Ryan, I think, having spent time with him, but I like him. I want to be around. I asked him if he wanted to come down, and of course, you know, he had expressed some interest and certainly the passion for the game, and try to stay in at some point. But the conversation I had with him a couple of days ago is, you know, why come on down, number one, and just get to know some of the people that are here, and even people that have been in the past. I mean, when you're a player, sometimes you're not that involved with them, and knowing he's not really a player anymore, so it's not going to be active with the players or something. But if there's something with Ryan that he wants to be, and what I told him is, if he wants to kind of be around a bit, or, you know, with on the scouting side, or I think with anything, like if you go to work at any company, you've got a training program. And I don't think, you know, I said to Ryan, if you want a job shadow, you want to do this, you want to learn about the, yeah, we'll provide that, but we're not going to throw you out and say, go get him. So if he wants to do that, if he wants to learn a little bit, be around, like, from talking to him, he could certainly be a real asset. So we'll see what that takes him and take us. And so it's nice to have him around and get to know him, and I heard a lot of good things about him, and I certainly realized that over the last couple of months having dealt with him.
How different have things been, versus your expectations? Do you know it was you like your first few months here, and has it been, because it's changed your people around here, has it been different for you?
Yeah, it's different for me just because there's, you know, a lot of new people for me, and, you know, I brought in a few different players, let alone some off-ice people, but majority of people are still here, and it's great to get to know them and work and understand my expectations and work together and have some fun as well. But it's been, you know, when these things happen, fortunately Lou was here for a few months with me, that, you know, was a real big help and on a lot of things. So, but when you start something, that's the excitement of it. And even 06-07 when I went to Pittsburgh, just the excitement, and not even over the first 3 months or 4 months, it's really over the first couple of years, you're just, you know, it's the excitement of the challenge, and B, putting a team together on and off the ice, and getting to know different people, and them getting to know you and how you operate. So from that standpoint, it's exciting, and you know, it's good to have this day come finally. So it's been a few months of, you know, finally see the ice. That's nice.
Well,
when everything is so much new, and you have your first game in 2 days after practice, that's kind of short, isn't it?
Yeah, no, but every team is in the same boat, and you can play on the third day, and teams get right at it. And you know, the good news for us, I think, especially with new management, new coaching staff, and so forth, and some players here in tryouts or getting to know it's the competition we talk about. And we have 7 exhibition games, which is really good. And you know, players that, you know, whether it's in scrimmage or in practice, earn some opportunity to make some changes and give them chances in the games. But it is quick, but this day and age, the players come in great shape and they're ready to go. And you know, those first few exhibition games are a little rusty in terms of execution, but you got to start somewhere. And I'm sure the guys will be ready and excited about playing on Sunday.
Did the health of Eliash or Boucher impact who you brought in on the tryouts, or would they have happened regardless?
No, I think they would have happened regardless, and those are players we've been talking to. And you know, even when Reed was injured in Buffalo, and certainly with Patrick, I didn't know when he got back if this would be something he could practice right away or not. And I think with anything, it's, as I said, it's more competition. We're trying to do better as a team and provide depth, and you know, we're trying to get better. And whether it's Lucy getting signed the last day, or whether it's Lee Stepniak or Tyler Kenny coming in, these guys have played in the NHL, they've contributed, and they're going to be, you know, pushing for jobs. And Talusti signed, obviously, but, you know, Stepniak and Kennedy had other opportunities elsewhere. They came here, they see some chances, and if it works out, that means they've done a good job, and maybe we're a deeper team doing that. But, you know, whether it's not, to me, taking away any chances for younger players, and it's not the younger, everybody's pushing each other, and just because you're on a one-way contract or a veteran, we're not going to get better unless there's competition. And I'm not looking at anybody's getting blocked or someone that's been here and is going to have a job. I think it's the competition that both myself and John want, and that's what we need.
Was it difficult at all to decide whether or not to give Talusti the contract or see him go to the KHL? Or was that?
No, I think, you know, he was real good about it. Same with Kennedy and Stepniak. Other people we had talked about, he had other options. He had another offer in the NHL, and let alone the KHL. And you know, it's, to me, you know, I don't know if I want to take that chance to a certain extent. And we like him as a player. He's at the right age, and you know, he's a younger guy, and there's opportunity for him here. And for him, where it would be a year from now as a 20-year-old free agent again, I think it's important to get the right situation. And for him, you know, his first choice would stay in the National Hockey League if at all possible, and the last choice maybe is going to the KHL. So for him, it worked out, and hopefully it'll work out for us as well. And you know, we're looking at some skill and some NHL experience if we could. And the byproduct of that is, you said, Tom, is, you know, with Patrick not being able to start camp. We'll see where that goes, but you know, I feel better about having added him. And even bringing in, you know, Tyler, who I know well, and at least them, yeah, for competition. And, you know, if they can push for jobs and make us a better team, or they'll get opportunity for sure.
Did Boucher take a hit to the head, or did he fall and hit his head, or anything like what exactly happened?
He was, it's really hard just because he played the game, and he gave a couple hits and got hit. We looked at the video, and, you know, we're, he goes, I think it might have been this one, but I really didn't, you know, he felt okay, and then maybe after this, it didn't feel as okay. Then we, you know, the trainers, they took him out of the game, and the more, and those are the things. And even going through this with Ryan Clough, the last game he played November 6th, Ryan, which hit was it? He goes, I'm not even sure, I didn't really get hit. And that was the problem. But with Reed, I mean, with Boucher, it was, there were some more physical
right.
hits. You know, he got after pretty good in the game. So good news is, he was taken out, and good news is he's feeling better. And again, the most important thing is being cautious with us. There's plenty of time, and you know, he's a young kid, time on his side.